Good morning, friends. Today we'll talk about the implicit human-computer interaction used in wearable and implanted smart device. So in the post-human model, the technology can be used to extend a person's normal conscious experience and a sense of presence across the space and time. So there are three types of post-human technology: accompanied, wearable, and implants. So in accompanied technology is a technology external to the body which accompanies it, but it is not directly attached to it. For example, the personalized mobile devices, smart cards and smart keys, and so on. Wearable technology is a technology external to and directly attached to humans. For example, the hearing aids and the wireless earpieces attached to the mobile phones to support the hands-free use of phones. Whereas the implants are the technology internal to the body. The obvious application for implants are medical, to use various prosthetic and bio implants to overcome the paralysis in the limbs and muscles, to help regulate and treat irregular biological phenomena such as the heart activity, and so on. Well, the wearable includes a combination of ICT devices. Now, wearable computers are especially useful when computer access is needed while a user's hands, voice, eyes, or attentions are actively engaged within the physical environment. Now, the entire focus of wearable computer interaction is on the multimodal interaction, which includes the visual interaction too. So the visual mode systems, they are basically divided according to how human interact with the system. So based on that, the visual modal systems are categorized. So visual interactions can be classified into command and non-command interface based visual interaction. So non-command vision based analysis systems, generally they have four stages. So first stage is always the motion segmentation, where the moving object is segmented. Then in the second stage, the object is classified. Okay, object classification is performed and the target object is tracked. And finally, the information from the target object captured or detected or tracked is being interpreted. So these are the four vital stages in the non-command based vision based analysis. Okay, now many researchers, they have contributed to the advancement of wearable computing. Perhaps the most important pioneer of wearable computer is the Steve Mann. His first early main application, which was focused on recording personal visual memories that could be shared with others via internet. And in the next slide, we are going to see how this wearable computer technology, it is evolved over the period of years. So 1980, the Steve Mann has introduced this wearable computer technology. In the mid 1980s, slowly, early in the 1990s, then mid 90s, and in the late 1990s, you can see that the wearable computer technology or the visual interaction is being evolved over the period of years. So Mann's has defined three criteria for wearable computing. So the first Mann's criteria is eudaimonic criterion. Now, eudaimonic criterion is basically, it defines that the ICT device appears to be the part of user as considered by the user and the observer of the user. In existential criterion, the ICT devices are controllable by the user. Now, this control need not require any conscious thought or effort, but the locus of control must be such that it is within the user's domain. The third Mann's criteria, which is called as ephemeral criterion, it actually indicates the interactional and the operational delays which are non-existent or very small. So operational constancy or operational delay is basically, it is always active while the device is wearable on the human body. Whereas the interactional constancy, which is one or more output channel in which the one or more output channel are accessible to the user at all times, not just during the explicit human computer interaction. So you wearable computers, because they can accompany users everywhere, they represent a clear form of ubiquitous computing, a more complete conceptual framework for wearable computing. It is sometimes also called as the humanistic intelligence, and which considers the informatic signal which flows path between the individual and the computer. Okay, there are some different types of wearable computer, and the thing is that all these different types of wearable computer does not meet the man's criteria. So in next slide we are going to learn these different types of wearable computer. So the first type of wearable computer is heads-up display, HUD. Now heads-up display or HUD is any type of this display that presents the data without blocking the user's view. Now this technique was pioneered for the military aviation and is now being used in commercial aviation and cars. So there are two types of heads-up display. First is fixed heads-up display and other is head-mounted heads-up display. So in a fixed heads-up display, the user looks through a display element attached to the airframe or vehicle chassis. The system projects the image with semi-transparency onto a clear optical element and the users view the world through it. In head-mounted display, the system precisely monitors the user's direction of gaze and determines the appropriate image to be presented. The user wears a helmet or other headgear which is securely fixed to the user's head so that the display element does not move with respect to the user's eye. The second, the other types of wearable computing devices are ITAP and the virtual retina display. Now ITAP is a device that is wear in front of the eye that acts as a camera to record the scene available to the eye and act as a display to superimpose a computer generated imagery on the original scene available to the eye. An ITAP is similar to a HUD, heads up display, but it differs in a way that scene available to the eye is also available to the computer that projects the heads up display. Now this enables the ITAP devices to modify the computer generated scenes in response to the natural scenes. Now the next the wearable computing device is virtual retinal display. Now virtual retinal display, which is also known as the retinal scan display, which draws a raster display directly onto the retina of the eye. The user sees what appears to be a conventional display floating in a space in front of them. Now this is in contrast to past system that have been made by projecting a defocused image directly in front of the user's eye on the small screen, normally in the form of large sunglasses. So this is what the virtual retinal display, the wearable computing devices are likely to be. There are some other wearable computing devices which are in the form of clothes as a computer. So unlike the heads-up display, ITAP and a virtual retinal display that focuses on a single sensor, on the counterpart, the clothes as a computer, which uses the network of sensors that can be viewed and the data from them fused to allow other types of non-visual context awareness. So these are some different types of wearable computing devices. Okay, in this slide we are going to learn about the brain computer interface, or which is typically called as the brain machine interface. Now